How to set smart goals with vision boards. Tom Steyer quote, clarity of vision is the key to achieving your objectives. Now that you know the results you want and your intentions for clearly achieving them, it's time to begin developing and setting your goals. Focus on the feeling you want to experience once you achieve your goal. This might be security, happiness, strength, love, peace, joy, creativity, accomplished, successful. Then determine the actions you need to take to guide your course down the road to success. Please subscribe to get updated with more videos and click the bell to get notified too. Comment below with subscribed. The first step is to create your goals. Use the SMART method of goal setting for this. You already know that setting goals is necessary for success. However, using the SMART principles for setting your goals helps you succeed sooner. Use this formula to create your SMART goals. Be specific. The more you can detail down your goal, the better it is. Get as focused and well-defined as you can. Instead of saying, my goal is to lose weight, a better, clearer statement would be, I want to lose 20 pounds so I can keep up with my kids. Getting down to the specifics of your goal can be achieved by using the 6 W's of journalism, who, what, when, where, why, and how. The WHO is you and the people who need to be involved in the process. The what is what you want to achieve. Get very detailed here. The when is the date or time frame you will achieve the goal. The where could be your location when you achieve the goal or where you expect to see a result of some type. The why is the reason you want to achieve the goal. Why will it be beneficial? The how is how will you get there or the steps you will take to achieve the goal. Measurable. Include specific amounts. Avoid using vague words. Exchange words like better, more, or happy, for example, with words that specifically make you feel this way. Think about what the vague word means to you and how it affects your future. Would be in better shape, help you understand and know when you've reached your goal of better shape? Better shape than what? Instead, make the goal something more specific. I want to lose 20 pounds and become flexible so I can play with my kids without becoming winded, is a more measurable goal with specific words. Attainable. Set your goal so that it is actually achievable. Yes, you want to challenge yourself, but saying you will lose 20 pounds in 3 weeks isn't a reality. It will only frustrate you and lead to disappointment if you set your goal too high for the time frame. When determining a reasonable time frame for your goal, think about how much time you have in a day to devote to working on your goals. Then set your goal accordingly. A more realistic goal then would be, I will lose 20 pounds in 6 months. Relevant. Is your goal relevant to the direction you want to go in your life? Does it align with your strengths and values? Do you have the talent and experience to, or can you attain them, to reach the goal? Is the goal worthwhile for you? Is this goal moving you forward? Consider these questions when you are setting your goals. For example, if your goal is to become flexible and healthier within 6 months, setting a goal to eat out more might not be relevant to your main goal. Time-bound. Your goal needs a time-based limit or deadline. Without one, you'll be tempted to procrastinate or ignore your goals altogether. It's easy to get distracted by tasks that aren't in your goal plan. These tend to impede meaningful progress. Your time limit depends on the goal. You'll want to allow a longer time frame for some goals based on the information you need to collect and the tasks you need to complete. Just be sure to keep it really effective for your needs. The specific SMART goal setting formula should be applied to your vision board. Begin creating a vision statement that motivates and resonates with you, personally. Play around with different statements until you find the one that feels right. Consider all of your life areas. Make your goal or vision statement specific. A general statement like, I want to have a better life, isn't as powerful as one that includes specifics like, I want to live in the mountains, writing books, and knowing I've made an impact on others. Consider focusing on a single goal for your first board. Once that one is created, you can create other boards for each of the major areas of your life. Depending on your preferences, you can make one specific to your business life and one for your personal life. However, be aware that there may be goals that cross over into multiple life areas. Choose one board where the goal will be housed. This helps you refrain from running. Using the SMART formula for setting your goals helps you get specific on what you want in what amount of time. Digging deep into your feelings, wants, and the time frame that is actually achievable allows you to know exactly what you want to achieve. 3 categories for goals. Another thing you want to consider when setting your goal is identifying the type of goal you are reaching for. Goals can be categorized into 3 main categories. 1. Time goals are goals that are either short-term or long-term. Short-term goals are quicker to achieve than long-term goals, obviously. These goals are something you want to achieve in the near future. They are anywhere from a day to up to a year's time. Longer-term goals are any length of time after 1 year. A good rule is to create long-term goals in ranges of 1, 3, 5, and 10 years. 2. Focused goals point to the big goals, the things that are life-changing achievements you want to accomplish. Most of these goals will fall into the long-term range. They might have several steps that have to be accomplished along the way. For example, if your goal is to, I will fly my own plane across Alaska within 3 years, one of the steps you would have to achieve first is to learn to fly a plane, get your pilot's license, and buy a plane. 3. Topic-based goals are goals that are related to specific areas of your life. They could be an aspect of your career, your finances, or your personal life. For example, you might have a career goal to be promoted to management by the end of the year, while your personal goal might be to run a 5K race within 6 months. Most likely, your goals will land in more than one of the categories in any combination of the categories. Whichever categories your goal falls into, they need to be specific and resonate with you while still being achievable. Goal examples. Now that you know how to create a goal, here are some examples of both broad and general goals, as well as 7 specific examples to help you get started. Business, career life. 1. I want to start a business. 2. I will sell handcrafted jewelry through Etsy.com within 6 months. 3. Within a month, I will set up my Etsy shop to sell handcrafted jewelry that will allow me to benefit financially from my hobby. Within 6 months, I will have an inventory of 90 pieces of jewelry and will sell a minimum of 8 pieces per week. I will build customer relationships through referrals, networking, and word of mouth. 4. I want to write a book. 5. I will write 1 chapter a month. 6. I will research, write daily, and find a publisher for my book. 7. I will write a 150-page book on self-care by writing 5 pages a week. My book will be completed within 10 months. I will have my book edited and self-published in a year. 6 personal life examples. 1. I want to be healthier. 2. I will eat more fruit and vegetables, cut out processed food, and eat less meat. 3. Within 6 months, I will be only eating unprocessed and whole foods. 4. I will run a marathon. 5. I will run a 10K marathon over the next 6 months. 6. I will win the local marathon name within the next 3 years. Use these examples as a starting point on creating goals that resonate with you. Goals should be personal, specific, time-bound, and make you feel good about yourself, as well as see yourself as being power-filled and successful. 9 other things to consider. Here are a few other things and ideas to consider when setting your goals and intentions for your vision board. The tips here give you what you need to remember as you move through the process. 1. Focus on the why or benefits behind your goals. Choose images based on your why instead of just material benefits. 2. Set your intentions based on what you want to achieve. If the goal of your vision board is to be healthy, pasting images of specific healthy food, phrases on how you will feel when you're healthy, images of the exercises you'll do, and people enjoying themselves are perfect for your board. 3. Put your vision board where you will see it every day. It should remind you of your reasons and the benefits of making changes. This helps keep you on track to achieve your goals and reach your desired way of living. 4. It can be helpful to incorporate things that contrast with your positive goals. In short, include things that also remind you of what you no longer want in your life. You can do this in an unobtrusive way, such as on the back of your vision image. For example, if you constantly worry and have negative thoughts, write them on the back of the images, so you don't focus on the negative too much. 5. When you complete this side, draw an X through the whole thing. As an alternative, create a let it go board. Once you have truly let something go for a specific amount of time, take that item off the board and trash it. This act of letting go helps you to make room for the new habits, thoughts, people, and things to come into your life. 6. An alternative to creating your list on the back of your let it go vision board, write out your specific goals. Try to keep it short and sweet so you can remember the goals even when they aren't right in front of you to see. 7. State each goal as a positive, similar to the way you write affirmations, using I am phrasing. On your vision board, use positive phrases, quotes, and images for your goal reminders and motivation. 8. In your goal, include as many important details as possible by including times, dates, amounts, and other elements you need to track or keep in mind as you make progress. Be sure to include them on your vision board to help you see how far you've come and about how far you have left to go. 9. Prioritize each goal. Work on one goal at a time so you don't get overwhelmed by juggling too many goals. Prioritize and sequence which goals you'll tackle first and foremost. Try to keep this low-key and simple to maintain the joy and enthusiasm factors, which help you make steady progress. Use these tips to set up your vision board so your goals align with what you want to achieve and how you want your life to change for the better. Setting goals and intentions. Setting your goals and intentions is the most important step in creating a vision board. Knowing what you want to achieve, how you plan to accomplish it, how your life will benefit, and how you will know when you achieve each goal is essential to your success. These are key elements to creating a vision board that inspires and motivates you to keep making progress. Here are 6 key points to remember as you think about creating your vision board for maximum effectiveness and ultimately, your success. 1. Goal setting is an important part of creating a vision board. Without integrating your SMART goals, you're just creating a collage of things you might want. 2. Taking time to think about and develop your goals helps you decide what you want to achieve in every area of your life. In addition, it gives you the opportunity to envision what each successfully met goal looks like to you. 3. When you set your goals, you must prioritize what is most important to attaining your success. In addition, this process enables you to eliminate things that don't fully support the achievement of the goal you set. 4. Goal setting helps motivate you when you are excited about getting started, you're not sure where or how to begin, have lost your interest or enthusiasm, feel discouraged by a hurdle, doubt yourself, are tired of trying, discover a new reason to keep making progress, and in many other situations. 5. Setting goals builds your self-confidence as you make progress and achieve your goals. When you are able to see the progress you make, you become more confident in your skills and abilities. Every bit of progress you make, even if it occurs at a slower pace than anticipated, is still progress. This encourages you to keep trying, which is actually the key to your overall success. 6. Setting goals helps you to identify what works and what needs to be adjusted. You may feel discouraged, but realistically, you learn how to go with the flow and develop your flexibility, which also leads to being more resilient. Here is a little secret for you. All successful people are very resilient. Work on it. Begin by setting your overall life goals. Then, set smaller goals in specific timelines like 5-year, 3-year, 1-year, 6-month, 1-month. Break your goals down into smaller goals you need to achieve in order to reach your lifetime goals. Once you have your goals set, start thinking about the types of things you want to use to represent them. Will you use images of specific things, words or phrases, quotes, or a combination of items? Please subscribe to get updated with more videos and click the bell to get notified too. Comment below with subscribed. Next, you want to determine the intention of your vision board as it relates to your goals. Will it be for one specific area of your life, such as your health or finances? Will it be an overall picture of your life? Finally, start gathering your supplies to create a vision board that represents what you want to accomplish. You want it to inspire you every time you look at it. Most of all, when setting your goals and designing your vision board, have fun, and let your imagination have free rein on what your life could be like.